Hello, my name is Hadrian Parker, and I am a Senior Analytic Training Consultant with Analysis Prime University. In this tutorial, I will use a recursive formula to create a calculated measure that can be used in a planning table. By the end of your tutorial, you'll be able to understand what a recursive formula is, use a recursive formula in a calculated measure, and use recursive measures in a planning table. A recursive formula is a mathematical description that describes how a number in a sequence is calculated from the number before it. If you have a list of numbers from 1 to 10, the recursive formula is, from the second number, each number is the number before, plus 1. If you had a list of exponential values starting at 1, each number is the number before times 2. Recursive formulas can be applied to calculated measures in models in SAC. This model has details about 3 loans: a mortgage, a car loan, and a personal loan. For each loan, there is a loan amount, the annual interest rates, and the amount being paid back every month. What I want to know is how much of the loan will be left after each monthly payment after the interest is applied. This is a recursive formula. Under the workspace dropdown is the calculation section. As the APR is applied monthly, I have a calculated measure that divides the interest by 12. I shall create a new calculated measure for my remaining loan amount. The recursive formula function is called iterate. Type in this in the formula area shows 3 parameters. The first is the recursive formula. Prior is the function to look at the previous value. My formula is the previous value minus the monthly payment, then increasing this amount by the monthly interest. The next parameter is the initial amount, so I'll add the loan amount. The last parameter is the interval between each new number. As this is over time, I shall add date. The preview shows how each payment reduces the remaining loan. In this story, I am using the earlier model to display the 3 loans. I can now add the recursive calculation to any table and chart that is using date. At the beginning of 2020, I want to increase the annual payments for the mortgage to 90,000. If I update this transaction on a table, you can see that the monthly payment has increased, but also the remaining loan has decreased each month. If I increase the payment for March for car repayments, you can see that this affects the payments and the loan amounts remaining for all the dates from March onwards. To recap, you should now be able to understand what a recursive formula is, use a recursive formula in a calculated measure, and use the recursive measure in a planning table. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, click the like button below. You can also view our growing catalogue of self-paced courses, tutorials, webinars, and join the community forum by creating your free account at analysisprimeuniversity.com.